So yes, it looks like a lot of our predictions came true, and a lot of our guesses are not true, depending on what happens in the next month or so, but Apple will be releasing a product red iPhone XS and XS Max. But this article is saying it's going to be exclusive to China, which I've never seen Apple do color-exclusive things for different countries. However, sales for China are incredibly low, but at the same time, why not lower the price of the iPhone XR? The XS in China is not going to sell very well at all, but regardless, once again, the important thing to remember here is salt is a way of life. Take everything with a grain of salt. None of this might not happen, but here's what the analysts, here's what the reporters are telling us as of today. So the first bit of not so fun news is that a lot of people are saying there is going to be an Apple event on March 25th held at the Steve Jobs Theater, which is usually where Apple announces pretty big things. But reporters right now are saying the March 25th event is going to be about services and you should not expect new iPads, new AirPods, or anything really all of us care about, which I find particularly bizarre because it's been a very, very long time since Apple has simply just held an event simply to showcase services. And if they are launching several services, which I do not doubt they are. We've been hearing about Apple's movie streaming service or TV streaming service for years now. It's long overdue. Absolutely, Apple, I get it. Go ahead, launch it. But we're now also hearing about Apple's news magazine subscription service, which will give you better news articles than the standard Apple News. I don't know. Maybe it just removes ads or sponsored articles or things like that. But regardless, if you're hosting an event just to launch two services, I honestly think the Steve Jobs Theater would be overkill, which is why I kind of doubt a lot of the people suggesting that this event is purely going to be about services, nothing else, because there's a lot of other analysts telling us different things about products that are about to come out. And we also have history on our side to remember that the past three years, there's been some type of event held in the beginning of the spring. And in fact, for the past 3 years, we've gotten technically new iPhones at all of these March events. I don't mean brand new iPhones. I don't mean new redesigns or anything like that. But let's look at the history for a second. In 2016, the March event, which was actually live streamed, had the new 9.7-inch iPad Pro, and it also had the iPhone SE. In 2017, we got that budget iPad with the A9 chip alongside the product red iPhone 7 and iPhone 7 Plus. In 2018, we kind of got an event, but it wasn't live streamed, but we got the redesigned 2018 budget iPad with the A10 chip and Apple Pencil support. And even right before that, they launched the product red iPhone 8 and iPhone 8 Plus. Perhaps the reason for Apple not providing a product red or a color refresh to the regular iPhone 10 is because parts back then were still very much limited in supply. Face ID sensors were still very, very new, and it was difficult for Apple to diversify that iPhone 10 lineup, except now we know because of the 2018 lineup that Apple's kind of figured out that manufacturing process. They've got it down now. We've got all kinds of iPhone 10Rs in multiple different colors. So perhaps this year, it makes sense to me as to why we're seeing reporters right now suggesting that Apple is working on a product red version of the iPhone XS and XS Max. And while it makes sense that maybe for the context of the article that this is only going to be launched in China, the article also doesn't explicitly say that it won't be available anywhere else. In fact, they say, we know that at least it's going to be available in China, which knowing Apple and knowing how they've never really done color exclusives for specific countries, I don't think that Apple would make a product red XS just for China. I personally think that when I see this article and they're saying that the product red XS is in development, that's going to be a product for the entire world. The only difference with this version of the iPhone XS is they're saying they may drop that official product red tagline that Apple's products have had for such a long time. If you buy a certain product that's labeled with product red, it goes to support a charity. And they're saying that perhaps with this phone, because of the very, very low sales they're experiencing in China, it's going to drop the product red name. That could mean that we'll see a red XS and a red XS Max in the United States, but the rest of the world will get that product red tagline. And that means that if anyone else buys one, a percentage of the profit will still go towards the Red Foundation. And then, of course, the good news there is that all of us get more color options to go forward with to those of us who have not upgraded yet or are thinking about getting the XS or XS Max. Apple iDesigner has designed these incredible concepts, and I know I've promoted them in the past, but I'm gonna keep doing it until you follow him, until every single subscriber of this channel is following him on Twitter and Instagram, so make sure you do that. But once again, yeah, he has designed some awesome artwork to showcase what a product red stainless steel body would look like with that product red glass on the back. I think it looks absolutely amazing. And to those those wondering out there, yes, I would absolutely buy one. I know I just switched to the XR, but even if this thing comes out, it's probably not going to be till April, so I'm still going to get extensive use with the iPhone XR. But if this thing comes out, I am so getting that because it looks incredible, and that would be my daily driver. As MKBHD has talked about in the past, releasing a red version of your phone kind of halfway through your product cycle is a good way to get a lot more eyes back on your phone because people see it in this new finish. And also a ton more people might be incentivized to go out and buy one, as I still, to this day, see a ton of people out there using product red iPhone 7s and product red iPhone 8s. They're very common, even though they came out halfway through the smartphone release cycle, and a lot of people probably wouldn't be considering the XS or wouldn't be considering the 8 or the 7 in the March-April timeframe if Apple had not refreshed them with this new color finish. So, in my mind, given Apple has done this the past 2 years, it makes sense that they would do it again in 2019, and that's why, while we're hearing about the Apple TV subscription service, and we're hearing about the Apple Magazine subscription service, and those are going to be the highlights of the event, I still think we're going to get at least one new budget iPad. It might be the iPad Mini 5, it could be the new 10-inch iPad, but regardless, we're going to be getting some type of budget iPad alongside a new red iPhone XS. I think that makes the most amount of sense if Apple's going to go. I think that makes the most amount of sense, and if not, this is really going to be a sucky keynote, because I'm interested to see all the original content Apple's been working on. I'm interested to know what the advantages of this Apple News subscription service is. Is it one bundle? Are you going to be able to bundle all these things together with Apple Music and make some kind of really exclusive deal that makes it worth it to people? I don't know. I'm curious. But on top of that, I think all of us know Apple's king of making aesthetically pleasing hardware, and we all love to see hardware announcements, and given we've had hardware announcements for the past 3 years, to me, it makes the most amount of sense that we're going to be seeing some type of product refresh or new color finishes within the next couple months. OnLeaks has also mentioned that AirPods 2, which we talked about a few days ago, is not going to be coming out till the fall, which bums me out a little bit, but it makes sense. I think a lot of people were commenting that, like, why would Apple release such a big upgrade to AirPods right when AirPods are getting super popular? As everything Apple Pro said, AirPods are growing in popularity insanely fast. Everyone's buying them. They're the second best-selling Apple product right now. So why refresh them in the middle of all this? Why not wait a little bit longer, wait for the hype to kind of die down before you refresh AirPods entirely? And I think what OnLeaks has suggested makes a ton more sense. He's saying AirPods 2 is not coming until the fall. However, the optional wireless charging case that will ship with the first generation AirPods, that will be available fairly soon, which lines up with a lot of our predictions about AirPower to being available to purchase within the next couple months. Perhaps at this next March/April timeframe, they will launch AirPower alongside the wireless charging AirPods. That way they can say, this is the best way to charge your new AirPods. And given that's the last piece of the puzzle to make AirPower kind of useful, given AirPower was always advertised with AirPods, watch, and phone, well, what if they released AirPower, but the wireless charging AirPods didn't exist yet? It wouldn't really make sense to release it. But we've been hearing from several people that AirPower is in production and that they're getting ready to release it. It's going to be slightly thicker than originally advertised, so it sounds somewhat believable to me that within the next couple months, we might not get AirPods 2 or the complete refresh with new color options and the new matte finish, but we will get that optional wireless charging case. We will get the release of AirPower, finally. And now seeing this report of Apple making a product red XS, I can only help but say that this all seems like tradition. Apple's noticed that they get significant success and a big boost in sales when halfway through an iPhone cycle, they release a red version of it that's gonna bring a lot more eyes to the XS and make a lot more people wonder, should I spend that extra money to get that stainless steel and that red color? It looks really good. And I still think that it would make the most amount of sense for Apple to launch their new subscription service and their TV service alongside a budget iPad to just be like, hey, it's gonna be available to the masses, and here's a new iPad to showcase how good the new services work. I think that would work perfectly. So let me know what you guys think's gonna happen, what's not gonna happen, what are we getting our hopes too high for? Is it just gonna be a services event and we're not gonna see any hardware? All that good stuff. Let me know what you're thinking down in the comments below. This is your Apple Sheep here, and I will see you in the next one.